This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create a powerful spray paint grunge effect for text and images. For your convenience, I provided this grungy background of scratches, an image of a skull, a spray paint brush set, and a link to the font I'm using. Their links are in my video's description or project files. Feel free to use any image, font, or background you like. The first step is to separate our subject from its background. To do this, unlock the layer and open your Properties panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Properties. Click Remove Background. Photoshop automatically makes a layer mask of the skull, thereby masking out the background. We'll convert it into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. To do this, click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. We'll place it onto the scratch's background. If your Move tool isn't active, press V on your keyboard. Drag it onto the tab of the scratch's background and without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down and release. I'll center it on the background because I'm going to place text on both sides of the skull. Before we set our text, let's check our foreground and background colors. If they aren't black and white, press D on your keyboard. Since we want our text to be white, our foreground color should be white. If your colors are reversed, press X. Open your horizontal type tool and type picker. Pick a font you want to use for this project. I'll make its size 186 points, but feel free to adjust its size based on the font you pick and the number of characters in your text. I'll make the aliasing smooth and center alignment. Click on your document and type out your text. To adjust the spacing between the characters, highlight them and press and hold Alt or Option and the right or left arrow key on your keyboard. Open your Move tool and position your text. I'll make a copy of it for the other side of the skull. To do this, I'll press Ctrl or Command J. I'll press and hold the Shift key as I drag it to the right. Pressing Shift kept the text horizontally aligned. I'll double-click the large T of the top layer to highlight the text and type in my new characters. I'll open my Move tool and reposition the text. We'll convert the skull and the text into one smart object by shift-clicking the skull to make it and the other text layer active and converting the three layers into one smart object. Reverse the colors so black is your foreground color and go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Sketch folder and click Torn Edges. If you're using the skull image, make the image balance 28, the smoothness 15, and the contrast 12. We'll convert this into a smart object as well, so we can selectively restore portions of it later. Change its blend mode to screen. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Make the radius 8 pixels. Go back to Filter, Noise, and Add Noise. Make the amount 30%, Gaussian, and monochromatic. Next, we'll add a stippled, grungy spray paint texture to our image, and lastly, finesse it by restoring back some areas to make some edges look sharper. Click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask next to the skull. Make sure your foreground color is black, and open your brush tool. Open your brush picker, and scroll to the bottom of your brushes list. Open the spray paint brush set I provided, and feel free to use any of these brushes. Notice that 2500 pixels in size. We'll reduce it in a moment. Once you choose a brush, press Enter or Return. To reduce the size of the brush, make sure your caps lock key is off and press the left bracket key on your keyboard until you like its size. Then click over areas you'd like to add a rough stippled spray paint texture to. Feel free to adjust the size of your brush by pressing your bracket keys. If you don't like the last one you did, you can undo it by pressing Ctrl or Command Z. We can use other brushes as well. Just open back the brush picker, click another spray brush, reduce its size, and click over your image. Make the Smart Filter Layer Mask active, adjust the size of your brush, and click over areas of it you'd like to sharpen. Doing this applies black over the Smart Filter Layer Mask, which is masking out the effect of these filters on the skull.
This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.